Sanibonani nonke on this beautiful morning. I hope you guys are well and keeping safe. This is the power of healing with Uthabi, Udoctor Ungowe Ketelo. Thabi is not a doctor, but Ungowe Ketelo is. So before I start, I just want to share some insights with you guys. I've been awake since 3 a.m. preparing for this video, and reason being kuthi sengiyabona ukuthi ngiyaphushwa manje because I've been slacking on ama videos. Remember, we don't plan these videos. We get a directive from the spirit guides. So ngiyabona ukuthi cha isalukazi sesiba a bit impatient with me because angenzi umsebenzi. Remember, she knows, or they know, nekhehle ukuthi asebenza kanjani, kubani, ngasiphi isikhathi. So they do get impatient, guys, and I want to say this to some of you who didn't know. Spirits are very impatient. Spirits are very impatient. That is why when somebody books a consultation and they do not pitch on time, you get anxious. We get anxious. It's like you get into this zone of panic. And that's not you, that's them. Because remember, sisebenza ngabo. So they get very impatient. They have this thing with time. I'm still trying to figure it out. What is it about them with time? And when ngifuna kahle, I think it all has to do with the time in which some of them met their death. So that is why they are so impatient, so short-tempered. Akuna lento kuthi uzoyenza ngesikhathi sakho. That is why when you're supposed to do something, and I'm going to talk about this in my next topic, in this topic, when you have a calling and you're supposed to do izinto, if things don't go according to plan, or if maybe awunamandla enough to do things on time, you go back and you tell them, look, things are very slow, and this is because of finances. So ngicela ningibekezelele kancane until I reach that point where I do things kahle. Siyancenga laba fethu, akuncengwa thina sincenga bona. So yeah, so I think that is why since bangivuse ngo-3 just to prepare for this video, because I had to do a video last week. I was given directive to do a video last week, and angikayenzi, and I think that is why there's a lot of videos that I haven't done that I was supposed to do. So that's that. So you must know every time spirits are very impatient, all of them, not to your guidance or your guides only, but all of them, they're just very impatient. Yeah, so coming to a topic of today. So today I'm going to talk about my 15 months of intense self initiation. Basically, it's all about initiation, self initiation, some insights that I want to share with you through my experience, because there's a lot that's good different. I mean, it's different with all of us, with every one of us. Umuntu nomuntu unique, and ezakhe izinto zenziwa differently. So the topic is my 15 years of intense self-initiation, and the 25 plus years of personal training. So why do I involve that in self-initiation? Initiation, guys, is when you now start to work. Initiation, when you get into initiation phase, so uzosebenza. If anikusebenze ngabantu, so uzosebenza. Okay, you get the personal training which goes on for years, up until you get to a phase where now you are being initiated ukusebenza. Because all along you've been practicing. You've been practicing, you've been gathering skills, you've been gathering tools, you've been collecting izinto ozosebenzisa. Now, when you get to this phase of initiation, that's when you're going to start to work ngabantu. And now, what do I mean by work ngabantu? That's when you start now to get a directive on how to charge fees. And I will do a video about charging fees, explaining how do we get to charge abantu. But for now, initiation is where you get now. But okay, so you're seven manje, because there is a phase where you do it for free, and I'll explain it in this video as well. So initiation is when so kaluk sebenza, but you get personal training that goes on for years. And I did mention before that it I'm going to talk to do a video of my journey. But this is part of it. It's not all of it, but part of it. So yeah, let's start. So I wanna say this. Spiritual awakening of your calling. Spiritual awakening of your calling is not only about visions, dreams, the headache. I pelele lapho, guys. There's more to it. There comes a time where, and a lot of people abanes tunya would know this. Guna lomoya ovukayo. When you are carrying this spirit, guna lomoya ovukayo. There has to be this spirit that awakens. If you're listening to music, if you're listening to drums, if you're listening to a whistle, enchanting, drums, singing, you feel like ukita. You feel like you get into this space, ne? Because this spirit inside you is awakening at that moment. In terms of religion, as I am busy on go to vugumoya, because if you're going to rely only on visions and dreams and headaches, you haven't awakened that spirit that is inside you. And I'll explain it later. You haven't awakened that spirit. So when you listen to music, you end up in tears and you don't even know. You understand. You end up worshipping, and the deeper the tears, the deeper the worship. So that uzobona ukuthi kukho iyaphila lento, because if ingavuki then ayiphili. I gabi strong enough. Do you understand? You haven't reached that phase yet. So please, guys, do know it's not only about the visions and the dreams and the headaches. There's a lot that goes into this. For us, people sleep for 8 hours. For us, 8 hours is too long. I think I sleep for 2 to 4 hours a day. And then you get to a phase where they want you to sleep now during the day, because there's a message that's coming through, and that message has to come through a dream, because there's a lot of things that you have to see. So our patterns on how our routines are different to a normal person. Okay, so before I can talk about self-initiation, ngizoqala nge personal training, which I call self-training, because it's also part of the self-initiation. So now, when it comes to self-training, there's a lot. There's a lot of things that you go through, okay? And as you go through them, so it's personal training, your spiritual guides are not as interactive as much, because they want you to understand life or go through life by yourself to understand certain things. Some skills of dealing nabantu, you have to gather them. You have to gather them yourself. You have to learn through experience. I think when I did a video about Inzuza, I did mention it is a spirit of self-realization. It is a spirit of meaning, and it is a spirit of experience. So you have to go through his life so you understand things, so you shape yourself into what they want, or you are shaped into what they want from you. So you don't interact as much during the phase of personal training. Nah, because they come here and there when they guide you to certain things, because yes, we use the gift, because the gift has to grow. Yes, we use the gift because you already know you have a gift. I mean, you've at a certain stage in your life, or as a child, there's already been signs that you have a gift. But now you have to go through life, so you get meaning, you get experience, you get maturity, you get wisdom, you get skills that will equip you to work with abantu. So there is in personal training, you have to learn selflessness. You have to be selfless. First thing that I think that they do is take away pride. I think that's the first thing, to take away pride and ego, because if you've got those two, you're going to want to compromise some of the things that you do for people, or that how you interact with people, because pride comes in, because I won't do that, bazongithatha kanjani. So they take away that. That's the first thing that they take away, pride and ego, and not, they don't take the self-esteem for, or the self-confidence for you to be out there and interact nabantu in a manner of teaching. But the pride, the negative pride that we normally have, and the ego, that's what they take away. And they take it away through taking something dear to your heart, or doing something ezoba, you know, that will, you will feel like in a way, iyagehlisa umoya nesithunzi, but not necessarily, because for them everything is training and everything is part of your journey. So now, humbleness. You constantly have to be humble. Uzehlise, we sizehlisa every day, every time, even when you see that things are becoming like too much, you try to fix yourself, uzehlise, because even when talking to them, you need uzehlisa, you are a child to them. And so, do you understand? And also, guys, you have to understand, in the spiritual world, authority remains authority. We might be confused about the authority of a gender in this ordinary reality, or in this physical world. But in the spiritual realm, or in the spiritual world, the authority remains. Agna 50-50 lapa. If unekhehla, ikhehla is above all the time. Amakhehla, they are above. Omkhulu, they are above all the time. They are still the head. The man is the head. The man is the head in the spiritual world. So if umuntu nekhehla, guna this authority over the spirit of a woman. So I'm not saying abana mandla fanayo, or they don't have the same strength, but for them authority remains authority, guys. Kindness. You have to show kindness. You have to practice kindness. You have to be kind, inside and out. Not fake kindness. Inside and out, you do everything with a pure heart. Love and kindness basically the same. Pure hearts, you do it with a pure heart. Just go to, there are times when you feel like people misunderstand you, and in misunderstanding you, they undermine what you are or who you are because of your kindness and love. And it's not necessarily that you're showing it because you're slim, but the calling itself or the requirements is that you have to show love, you have to show kindness, which goes with empathy and sympathy. Because if you don't have love, you won't be able to feel what the other person is feeling, or you won't be able to sympathize with someone who's going through something. And even with people who are coming to consult, how will you sympathize and try to help if awuzange practice and know it to a broader view? And it's constant training that we have to do. It's a practice that you have to do all the time. Show kindness, sympathy, empathy, love, humbleness, selflessness, because of indlela oyiyo or indlela owakheke ngayo, your nature. We are trained every day, guys. It is a everyday training in life, and we get it training from everyday life. So when you experience things, when you go through things, when you take a career that leads to something and you have to do something at work, and that is personal training for a later stage. You might not understand it now, but later izabuya kuthi, oh, so what, the reason why I was doing this all along was because there will be a time when I have to use it to here, and ngizo explain nayo. Now, I spoke about a phase where you have to do things, a phase where you help using your gift for free. So in some qualifications, when you're doing a PhD of being a doctor, or where you do a psychology, when you do, I'm not sure about teaching, there is 200 hours of social responsibility that you have to do, 200 hours of voluntary work, okay? And that is why even with law, you get that you have to do pro bono work at some point. That is also part of what we do. We get is cut away. We have to use our gift or use our calling for free. And that is when you're going through the personal training phase. And mine, as an example, went on for, I think, the past 20 years or the past 18 years. But I had to help and with my calling, and sometimes it seemed like it was just motivation or it was just advice, but it was part of my calling. I had to help people. I think there was when it was starting to be intense was then in 2018, where I had to go and release someone. So when I say release someone, this lady was in between, where she couldn't cross over, or she was remaining in this life and couldn't cross over to that life, but there was no sign of life from her. And she could talk, but beseka semkhathini nje, where, you know, things that she said wouldn't make sense to a normal person. So I was called to assist, and I did. And that for me was the first time that I had to do that. And in doing that, I was glad because they told me in the morning. So I had to learn to refrain from eating and just to go there. It was an experience and it was wonderful, and I carry it even today, not knowing that when I was doing that then, there will be instances where I have to do it now, okay? So, spirits will show you everything all that you're going to need. So, when you gather things like tools, and it doesn't happen overnight. Abaveli baveza mapai wonke nawo nokuhlalo nanani. It's phase by phase by phase by phase. So at some point in your life, bazokubonisa ijazi. At some point in your life, bazokubonisa idugu. For me, it started with idugu, and then it went to intambo. Then it went to ibayi. You know. So as you progress with the calling, you understand. And then even sometimes you don't even understand why ibayi, and then you know why this ntambo, why this jazz, why you don't understand then, but bona they know, they are preparing you. This is your first stage, or this is your first step. So as you grow spiritually, zonke lezi zinto ziyahlangana, and you make sense of everything. Because in a lot of times, when journey yako starts, you don't know what's going on, okay? But in time, you will get to understand zonke lezi zinto lezi. I want to go now to initiation, which I did say was work. Now you've personally trained for all these years on these things, you've developed yourself. It's hard, guys. It is very hard. The personal journey, in ama tunnels, there's mountains, there's tunnels. It's not smooth. It's never been smooth. Sometimes you acquire a lot and lose the same lot. So it's not as easy as I'm making it to be. Because with all these things that you practice, you live with abantu, abazo turn into something else if you allow them. You live in an environment as of turn into something if you allow it. You live with you live on earth where there is spirits, where is negative spirits. There's a lot of things as in Zagalayo spiritually. If you are going to break from that, you are broken forever. Then I wanna go to initiation, as I did say. Kune ahamba kanje ama spirits. I think in my experience, and I'm going to explain it in my experience, I don't know about abanye abantu, I don't know about abantu abasedlozini, or abasebenzisa, aba initiator idlozi. So this is for me, iphehlo. La for me, nakusephehlweni lomoya, I had to mention that, iphehlo lomoya, self-initiating iphehlo lomoya, where you are dealing with the unseen. You are initiated by the unseen. So for a person who is living in this world, when you talk of self-initiation, they will not understand it. Guti, how come? Do you understand? Because we often have this idea that you have to go to someone. Here, usephehlweni lomoya, where you are trained and you are guided by the unseen world. So you are going to get confused. And I want to talk about the Ndawo and the Nzuza child, because I think I relate to both of them very well. Ndawo spirit and Nzuza spirit. And I'm not sure about Amandawe. I'm not sure about Nguni or Ndawo. I don't know how their things go on, and hence I said this is my experience. Now, those two spirits are going to confuse you in a lot of times. They are going to confuse you because they both have different requirements and different things that you have to do. Sometimes some of the things are similar and they work together, but you're not aware which is their hambisana. And sometimes, do you understand? And for those two spirits, you constantly have to visit intaba. I call it intaba, ihlane or amanzi. Ihlane forest, intaba, amanzi. You will be friends with those places because you are constantly needed there, or you are constantly called there, either to pray or ukuyophahla. But you are constantly going there. Now, in my space, ngimbethi kehla, right? Meaning the spirit that I'm carrying, ikehla. Okay? Bese ngiphethwe isalukazi, the spirit that guides and initiated me, isalukazi. Okay? And then bese kuba khona the other spirits that become your guardian, because uzothuma bona in some of the things. They have their own gifts that they bring to you, because as much as ngimbethi kehla and ngiphethwe isalukazi, I also need them for some of the things. And these are some of them are family members that had gifts themselves. So I do not angizukuba initiator bona. They are just seba amathonga, okay? Amathonga labantu. Agna onedluzi, or even the one that I engimpete or engimbete uyithonga. So that is why ngise pheshweni lomoya and I didn't go to ezintweni zedluzi, okay? And that's when I think I did explain ukuthi that's when amathonga are clean and everything has been done properly. Now, so as I said, khona umbethe okuwe that you carry, kube khona okuphethe, who's your guardian, who's your the lead guardian, or the lead spirit guide, or the chief spirit guide. And then kube khona lama guidance also that you're going to need. Not saying bona bana manja, but omuntu nomuntu is assigned to a different person for a different reason. Or spirit ne spirit is assigned to umuntu, omunye nomunye, for a different reason and different purpose. So when we get to initiation, that's when now you are fulfilling the purpose of the calling. As I said, it's now work. Now, as I mentioned, umdawu nentuza, guys, please consult sometimes to understand ukuthi nani kanjani, because umuntu nomuntu has two sides. You are like a coin, there's two sides. Do you understand? And that's where we get confused. Uhambe uyothwasa into ngasiyo, uhambe uyothenga amabhayi wamandla ongenawo. Okay, and then you get these people confused, which is kuzohamba kahambe kube ngathi awenzanga lutho, fanele ukuqalele phansi. So when you consult, or when you are being read, when you do e-reading, we get to see your spiritual assessment first, and then spiritual assessment versus the spirits that you're carrying or the spirits that are coming forth, because bona they will explain ukuthi bawobani kanjani, banani, they are calling, they explain everything. And I often say this to my clients when I set appointments, and not because I want to be fancy. I set appointments because I want to meet with these people, with these spirits, before you come in. I meet with them, read them first, get to understand them. Even if kona laba abangathi ba ngihlale ngithi amahlanya laba ba you know abeza ngolaka you know you get to know ukuthi okay ngizodila nomuntu nje fanele ngenze kanje because you don't want to faint phambi kweclient you don't want to get sick from carrying a spirit ongasazi so if I have to cleanse them before they come through so that when they come through to me now they are clean or I am prepared for them that is why we set appointments we asizama ukwenza isilungu la it is a requirement because you don't want funny things do you understand spirits kill guys I always say this spirits kill when you're going to carry a spirit esingaklinwanga esingakwenza and then sometimes people know ukuthi hey mina nginogogo nje so faneke qhamuka ugogo kanti ugogo bengekho clean ungibuze ngogogo mfenti because now you're calling an uncleansed spirit ezongulisa kwamina so that is why often I ask for paternal or maternal surname so that ngazi ngizodila nobani kanjani and then directive guys comes from them all the time with everything that we do with the videos that we do with the cleansing rituals or the rituals that you have to perform they tell you ukuthi wena fanele ke manje wena you don't just get we don't get it over like nje just you don't just decide from your thoughts ukuthi okay now I want to do this they have to say what the treatment is for you and the solution the resolution for you is this so in self initiation that's when now you have to be very you have to be have grown and be personally trained because sometimes everything comes as a message everything comes as a message or through a dream or vision or whatever or signs or things that you see going around so it is very very confusing if you don't know why isn't doesn't you need to get clarity because now these messages sometimes they are not as clear you're speaking to spirits here sometimes color do you know might be confusing sometimes I think with amabayi as well kunebayi ene head black kunebayi ene head red or a blue you understand so you need to they need to show you ukuthi which one exactly So what I often do is go to pictures and try to link what I've seen to into ordinary reality into engiyibonayo. Okay, you need to be clear of the directive that they give. So it's self initiation, guys. Hence I said mine started in September 2021 and hence I graduated on December 2022 15 months that was not ukuthi ngiqale lapho to know my calling that was when the purpose is now starting your purpose of who you are and what you are meant to do is starting so it differs from person to person but never ever say I'm done because as much as I have gone through the graduation I'm still not done. There are certain things also if I find in your sense of putting your cleaner because now each and every spirit, there's formalities for it. Each and every gift that they have given you, there's formalities for it. You don't just say, I need the package deal. There's no package deal. You will have to meet the requirements for all of them so that your kinto is seven, I need the right at lean. Okay, we are not here to confuse or misguide you the reason why we are spiritual mentors is for people to understand where they are going for us to heal the world for us to heal people who have been sick for years without understanding what is going on it is yes kuthi I've met this lady who said I've been to abogobela more than 3 and mangi phakathi kwe initiation then all of a sudden things don't go right I have ukuthi ngimstartise afresh and start ngendlela e right and It is very difficult because also you have to understand now you're dealing with umuntu who has lost hope of whether inti right or wrong. So when you come and say, now this is the correct way for you, ile bayeli nje befanele uqale ngayo from the word go, it starts being, you know, overwhelming for them. Kuthi ay yabona ke nalona uzongishiya edleleni. But you sometimes get clarity, sometimes consult, whether it's two people, do you understand? But also as a self-initiate, abantu also consult kube and whom you're going to get help from, bayabaveza, bayakubonisa always. Sometimes you might go for a consultation, ungena nje you'll feel ukuthi this place is not for me, or this person is not for me, or this person really anyekazangisisi. Ngisho umfundisi ungena osontweni, you can feel ukuthi hayi la kuyadlalwa or kanjani. That is the gift itself, tells you, guides you. And then this thing, guys, is self-initiation is very difficult. It's one of the most difficult initiation. And a lot of people think it's easy because it's not easy, because you have to pause everything to focus on this. So I don't know where the easy comes from, because even if your day changes, and then all of a sudden they want you to like dress up and do this and do that. So akuna easy. There's no fanciness in this. There's no easy way out. So it's very intense, guys. It's very intense in such a way that even your sleep patterns, your diet. And once, I think for me now, this is for me, when you get into the phase of the initiation, ukhlaba sometimes is no longer needed. And I think it depends on the spirits you're working with. Igazi alifuneki ezandleni zakho. And I think I speak to most of the people, the water children, I call them water children, the people who are guided by water spirits. Igazi, goodness, phase where it's not needed for you. Alidingeki. Awudingi ukulithinta, awudingi ukuhlaba. Ngeza alidingeki ngezandla zakho. So, basically, they change your diet. Uthola ukuthi into bongayidli, and then all of a sudden you have to eat it, and then kuzohamba-hamba when you're busy with this phase. In the middle of the phase, uyeke futhi. You understand? They change a lot of things. They change, like, there are times when you no longer need it outside at all. Do you understand? Sometimes uthu sahleli ngaphandle, I experienced this once before. Kwavele kwahlangana istorm nje, and I think that was just saying go inside. Like the way the storm was, it was like it was talking to me basically angry. Because you get to be connected with nature as well. And I think for me now, that's the because of the calling and the work that I do of medium and shamanism, you interact with nature. That's cool. So, and then, as I said, the things that you have to go through so that you get to this phase. I think with Abantwana Benzuza, as I mentioned, there's a lot of characteristics. That's singing. We sing like angels. Also, in Abantwana Bomda, we sing like angels. We sing so beautifully, and the creativeness. So when you get to the phase of initiation, your beats, uyazenzela, they want you to, because they give you a vision of how yours should be. And we are unique from person to person. They are not the same. You know, you get designs from, you get a directive of designs from them. So some of them, you do them yourself. Some of the beats, some of the bracelets that you have to get, bayakubonisa, and some are given to you as a gift by people, and then later on you realize, ay man, but this was part of my journey. The road, guys, the road is not for the journey. The road is for the destination. The personal training is not for the journey. It is for the destination. And where you get yourself initiated, when you get to the initiation and graduation phase, that's the destination. And in that destination now, it's going to guide you. Because sometimes you have to understand your own journey. You have to go through your journey so that other people can go through theirs. UJehova ukhuluma nomuntu kumuntu ngomuntu. God will speak, or the Spirit will speak nawe kimi for wena. To understand, and you have to know that. So this is not a journey of the road of the journey, but the road of the destination. So as I said, guys, you apply the training in everything now. That's when you start to apply the training in everything. In initiation, you will apply the everything that you have. That's where you get to apply everything that you have gathered through your personal training or your personal experience. Yonke lento le izosebenza when you get to initiation, believe me. Yonke into will be like, okay, when I was taught to do projects and all of that, that's because I had to do certain things. I remember when I first started ukuphothintambo, I never knew but I'll get to a stage when ngizophothintambo. And I just did it by myself. I was just, first time I did it, it didn't look right. But the second time I did it, I did it perfectly. And that's why I'm saying it comes with creativity. It comes with a lot of things that we do. You know, sometimes I even say we were even given the gift of being creative. Because the ideas just come flowing. You don't even follow recipes. You just do them by yourself, and it's very nice. The gift is unique, guys. The calling is unique. Use it ngendlela right. Self initiate yourself ngendlela right, step by step, slowly. Patient. The spirits are not patient, but you can be patient in learning, and it is a journey of pain and patience. I wanted to say this. This is self initiation. It's a journey of pain and patience. You will never say, ngenzile ungayizwangi pain. There is a time where you have to allow pain to work on you. You allow pain, you feel pain, you go through pain so that you will get to your destination. Go through pain, feel pain, don't lose yourself in pain. Don't lose yourself, don't lose focus because of pain. Patience will get you where you have to be. As difficult as patience is, because patience is a very, very, very difficult road, you will get there. Thank you for joining me. Please do subscribe to my channel, and I'm hoping that you guys have got the right guidance and you are going to get clarity and ask and consult if you are not clear. Thank you so much.